comfortable. These clothes are very soft. Okay. Next, these clothes are netted. You can see the netted cloth. In netted cloth, you also see varieties of nets. See, it is very thin. Okay. These clothes are also very soft. Okay. By touching, we can sense. This veil is very thin. Why this difference takes place in clothes? Yes. We saw different kinds of clothes. If when I visit cloth shop to purchase some cloth, shopkeeper shows varieties of cloth materials like cotton, silk, etc. Then I refuse to purchase the cloth. Okay, cotton, silk, polyester, these are called different kinds of cloth. Okay, cotton.
Fabric.
a piece of cotton fabric, try to find a loose thread or yarn at one of the ends and pull it out. Yarns are visible. You can gently pull out one out with a pin. Gently pull one out with a pin or a needle. We find that a fabric is made up of yarn arranged together. Take out a yarn from a piece of cotton fabric, place this piece of yarn and scratch the other end of the yarn along its length with your nails. Do you find that at this end the yarn split up into the strands? The thin strands of thread that we see are made up of still thinner strands called fibers.
100 years ago, we are using varieties of cloth. Okay, these varieties of cloths we get from some sources. Which are the varieties of cloths? Yes, cotton, wool, silk, jute. These are all called fibers. Our fabrics are cotton, wool, silk, jute. Okay, from where we get these fibers or fabrics? Yes, in older days we use only the natural source. See, cotton and jute. From where we get cotton? Cotton we get from cotton.
Okay, here cotton, wool, jute and Which are the main sources of food? Plants and animals are the main sources of food. In the same way, fiber or fabric we are get from plants and animals. Plants and animals. Here, plants and animals are the main source to get fiber.